Hi, good evening, everybody. Welcome to your, the fourth and final installment of the Counting Your Blessings weekend series for November. Your Turning Point weekend series for November. For the weekend of November 26th and 27th, and episode 4, .405, and it's the last numbers to be thankful for, and the number 1400, 1400. Our beginning passage is Revelation 21, 15 through 17 from the NLT, but I'll be comparing those verses when I read those verses in the recommended reading, Revelation 21, verses 10 through 17. And then our turning point today is from John MacArthur. And Bible reading for this weekend has been Romans chapters 8 through 14. So I hope you read 8, 9, and 10 and half of 11 yesterday. And read the rest of the 11 and 12, 13, and 14 today. Just to half it up for the weekend. So it's usually the way you do what the best way to do it. In my standards, it's the best way to do it. Unless you want to read it twice. But with that many chapters, it's good to break it down between the 2 days. And I only do the video one day. But it's supposed to be read it Saturday. Or they say you could do it either Saturday or Sunday, whichever one you. But I like to do it as a week. I try to put Saturday and Sunday. So this is for your Saturday, Jubilant Saturday, November 26th, and Glorious Lord's Day Sunday, November 27th. That's how it'll be in the description box and everything. That's how it'll be grouped up, so. And it'll be that way in the tags, too, so. But, if you're excited about this, we'll smash the like button. Remember, smashing the like button will help the video reach other people. And remember to get four likes only on every video until further notice. Take a watch of the beginning, the morning video for today, and it'll explain what the like challenge is all about. Mostly once a day I explain it. It's usually the morning video. So, take a listen to that part and see what I mean. But until further notice, it's 4 likes only. If it already has 4 likes, go to another video and help it get to 4 likes. That's all I could say. But counting your blessings, number 4, and the fourth and final numbers to be thankful for, and the number 1400, 1400, 1400. Starting off with Revelation 21, 15 through 17 from the NLT. Says the angel who talked to me held in his hand a gold measuring stick to measure the city, its gates, its walls. When he measured it, he found out it was a square, as wide as it long. In fact, its length and width and height were each 1,400 miles, according to the human standard used by the angel. So that's coming from NLT. So let's turn in our Bibles and look at the real version of those 3 verses, plus 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14 as well. Let's see what it says in my Bible. Revelation 21, 10 through 17. And he carried me away in the spirit to a great and high mountain, and showed me the great city, the holy Jerusalem, descending out of heaven from God, having the glory of God. Her light was like a most precious stone, like a jasper stone, clear as crystal. Also she had a great and high wall with 12 gates, 12 angels at the gates, and names written on them, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. 3 gates on the east, 3 gates on the north, 3 gates on the south, 3 gates on the west. Now the wall of the city had 12 foundations, and on them were the names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. And he who and here's 15. And he who talked with me had a gold reed to measure the city, its gates, and its walls. The city is laid out on a square. Its length is as great as its breadth. And he measured the city with the reed, 12,000 furlongs. Its length, breadth, and height are equal. Then he measured the wall 144 cubits, according to the measure of a man, that is, of an angel. So during the weekend devotions, we've been counting our blessings and looking at biblical numbers. So let's end with the number 1400. That's the cubic mileage of God's eternal capital city in length, breadth, and height. Just in area coverage, it's larger than India. But a city rising 1,400 miles into the sky, that calls for a huge planet, a supersized new earth, which God can easily create. But there is no number large enough for the days, years, or centuries will be there, for they are infinite and eternal. So when you think of heaven, don't think of a vapory existence. Our resurrection bodies will be modeled after our Lord's own, and we'll live with him in the new heaven, new earth, and his city of New Jerusalem, spending eternity counting our blessings. So why not start counting those blessings now? So John MacArthur says, heaven is a realm of unsurpassed joy, unfolding glory, undiminished bliss, unlimited delights, and unending pleasures. It will be a perfect existence. Okay. So that's all I have for you today. So, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and he'll keep you safe and all you say and do, 2022 and beyond. And until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. So long, farewell. Come back tomorrow for your last fantastic Monday of the month of November. We'll see what God has in store for us tomorrow, including, let me see, part one of episode 915, and we're going to be learning about conformity from Romans 8:29 from Henry M. Morris. Part two of 915, after one tomorrow, we're going to learn to walk with me from Sheraton Voysey, derived from Titus 2. 11 through 14. And tomorrow's episode 9 or 3 or 4, excuse me, 406, we're going to be learning about big and small. Psalm 8 verses 3 and 4 is our beginning passage. Psalm 111 is our recommended reading. Isaac Watts has the Turning Point. And there is a footnote at the end of the first section, right? In that section, there's a footnote there. We'll get to that. And your Bible reading is Romans chapters 15 and 16. So, stay tuned for those. I'll get to those sometime later tonight. But you'll see those tomorrow at 7 a.m., hopefully 1 p.m., and 7 p.m. So, 7, 1, and 7. That's usually how I do my weekday videos. And then my weekend videos are the two on Saturday are at, well, usually they're at 8 and 5:45. But with these bonus videos, I'm having to put that second one, I want to be trying about 2:45, 3 o'clock, and then have the other one at between 7 and 8. Depending on what. Which I'll have another bonus video next Saturday. And I have already got the new book, and I've looked. There is no R video coming up in those first 3 days. So we'll be good on that one. And really, there's only like two. I only counted like two more R videos in the whole book. So that one may not be used that often. So we're going to be good there having number 5 there. So number 6 won't be until probably sometime in January. So we're doing good on that. So, but it's what it is. But usually on the weekends I have it at 8:45 on Saturday. Then on Sundays I have it at 8 and 1:45, and then at 7 for the evening, for the weekend video. So, but it is what it is. So God bless everyone, and I'll see y'all tomorrow. Have a great rest of your Sunday evening, and come back tomorrow for another week. In the last few days of the month for this week, and see what God has in store for us this month. And pray that December's just as good when it starts at the end of the week. So, which will be Thursday? Yeah. Thursday's the first. So, we're going to shelter out November and start into December. And trust me, I already have my new books. So they're ready to go. So until tomorrow, goodbye.